Good morning, students. In the previous classes, we have completed genetic code. Before to genetic code, we have seen all the three types of rRNAs, mRNA, tRNA, rRNA structures. Genetic code, after the genetic code, mutations and genetic code, or genetic code and mutation, how to study genetic code easily, how to understand mutations. With respect to the genetic code, we have seen by giving the common example. Now, the process of translation. Translation is a process of polymerization of amino acids in the form of a polypeptide. So polypeptide means protein. In a protein, amino acids are present. How many present? Based upon that protein. So proteins are having polymers of amino acids as their structural components. It means a protein's building blocks are amino acids. So the process of translation means polymerization of amino acid. All these amino acids, polymerization means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all these amino acids represents one polypeptide chain or one protein. This process is called translation. How this is happening? When there is no complementarity between mRNA, what is responsible here? DNA is the director which is producing mRNA, and mRNA carries the information regarding the order of amino acid. The sequence of amino acid in a protein is depends upon the sequence of mRNA. Process of polymerization of amino acids in the form of protein is called translation. For this, the order and sequence of amino acids in that protein, order and sequence of amino acids in a protein are coded. The sequence of amino acids in a protein are determined by the sequences of mRNA or codons of mRNA. So mRNA is having codons, and according to these codons, specific amino acids are goes on forming, and all these particular number of amino acids is equal to one protein molecule. For this, what we require? We require so many requirements, so many. It is not so easy process like a single sentence of definition. The basic concept for translation process is this process of translation occurs in cytoplasm in a particular cell organelle called ribosome. So the process of translation occurs, or proteins are synthesized in ribosomes. Proteins are synthesized in ribosomes. Hence, ribosomes are called protein factories. Why ribosomes are called protein factories? Because the process of translation, it occurs in the ribosome. Then what is a ribosome? Ribosome is a protein factory. Then already we have studied ribosomes. One concept regarding ribosome. Ribosomes generally present in a cell freely in the cytoplasm. Ribosomes in a cell present in cytoplasm in the form of subunits. So ribosomes are present in the cytoplasm in the form of subunits. So generally prokaryotic ribosomes are called 70s types of ribosomes. Eukaryotic ribosomes are called 80s type of ribosome. In this present translation process, we are studying according to prokaryotic ribosomes. So a prokaryotic ribosome is called 70s type because of its sedimentation coefficient when it is exposed to ultracentrifuge. In the ultracentrifuge, based upon sedimentation coefficient, it is called 70s Swedberg units of sedimentation coefficient. And when we study this 70s ribosome, it consists of two subunits, a larger subunit 50 Swedberg units, a smaller subunit 30 Swedberg units. In eukaryotes, larger one is 60, smaller one is 40, both joins together to form 80s type. In this, we have seen in the previous class, it consists of structural components called ribosomal RNA. RNA, which are called rRNA, plus proteins. And proteins are approximately 32 different types of protein in the large subunit of prokaryotes. Here, ribosomal RNAs are rRNAs plus proteins, some 21 types of proteins are present in small subunit of prokaryotes. Here the rRNAs are two types, 23S rRNA and 5S rRNA. Again, we are repeating this because we require these, the requirements for translation process, the factory of protein synthesis. Proteins are rRNA molecules, 16S rRNA molecule. So three different types of rRNA molecules are there, and proteins are present in 50S, whereas in comparison, in 80S eukaryotic ribosome, 60S, 40S, Here, ribosomal RNAs, three types are there. 28S rRNA, 5S rRNA, 5.8S rRNA, along with 50 proteins are present. 50 proteins, 40S rRNAs are 18S rRNA, and it consists of 33 proteins. So here total amount of protein in eukaryotes, 50 plus 33, 83 proteins. Here total number of proteins, 32 plus 21, 53 proteins. Now, translation is a process of polymerization of amino acids in the form of a protein, which forms a protein, and it is by the direction of, by the codons of mRNA, and mRNA is by the direction of DNA. So the process of transcription means mRNA formation, and process of translation means the codons, coded information is decoded with the help of some adapter molecules like tRNA, with the help of so many enzymes and energy and factories of ribosomes. For this amino acid, next question. This ribosome, again, ribosomes in a cell present in cytoplasm in the form of subunits. But at the time of translation, they join together, associate, are assembled together at the time of translation. Two subunits assemble or associate, assemble together like a structure. And after the translation, again they disassemble or dissociate. Ribosomes in a cell. Again, in a cell, ribosomes are found attached to the endoplasmic reticulum, rough endoplasmic reticulum. In a cell, ribosomes are found attached to the ribosomes are also present, attached to endoplasmic reticulum and nuclear envelope. Nuclear envelope membrane. Sometimes ribosomes are found attached and also to cell membrane. So exceptional cases are there. Here ribosomes are present attached to endoplasmic reticulum because it becomes rough endoplasmic reticulum. Nuclear envelope, they are found attached, and they were found attached to the cell membrane. And ribosomes are present in some other cell organelles like mitochondria and chloroplast. They present in mitochondria and chloroplast. Here, organelle or ribosomes like mitochondria and chloroplast, they were not participating in the process of protein synthesis, translation. Now, what is a ribosomal subunit? What it consists of? For example, ribosomal subunit in prokaryotes. large sub unit has a sedimentation coefficient of 50 Swedberg units. It has three sites, places, A site, P site, E site. A site in the large subunit, in the large subunit of 50s, there are places, A site, amino acyl site, or acylation site, acylation site. We will see what is this amino acylation site, acylated site, P site. P site is called peptidyl site. Peptidyl site, PEPTIDYL, peptidyl site, amino acyl, acyl, acylation site or amino acyl site. E site, exit site. Exit means going, leaving out. All these three sites for the location of tRNA molecule, transfer RNA molecules. These are the locations of regions of tRNA molecules. Again, 30s subunit of prokaryote, 30s small subunit, it consists of some complementary sequences. Which binds with mRNA, some complementary sequences which binds with mRNA. It means, let us see the structure of mRNA in prokaryotes. In prokaryotes, mRNA 5 prime and 3 prime. At the 5 prime, just before the initiation codon, AUG initiation codon, some sequences are present which are called AGG, AGGU. I repeat, AGG, AGGU. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 nucleotides are present. They are called Shine, Delgarno, RSD sequences. Shine Delgarno, SHINEDALGARNO, Shine Delgarno sequences are specific sequences. Because of these specific sequences, this mRNA molecule of prokaryotes, in prokaryotes, it will go and choose the 30th smaller subunit of ribosome. When it approaches to this 30th smaller subunit, or identification, or binding, or attachment to the 30th small subunit, there in the some complementary sequences which binds to, and for these ASD sequences, anti-Shine Delgarno sequences are present. So this is the importance of 50S subunit having A site, P site and E site, three places, and 30S subunit having complementary sequences to bind with mRNA. Which complementary? Anti-Shine Delgarno sequences to the Shine Delgarno sequences which are here, a complementary. Because of this, a particular, a specific mRNA will go to a specific 30th subunit of ribosome.
Now,
the process of translation starts when, in the textbook, my dear students, they have given clearly, but in the textbook NCERT, they have given jumbled here and there, rotatory. Same sentence repeats. We easily, it is not acknowledged. That's why it is compulsory to understand in a systematic way. So first is translation process we have seen. What is translation? Polymerization of amino acids. What are amino acids? Polypeptide chain. What is mRNA? Polynucleotide chain. So here what complementary? There is no complementarity is existing. Even though that sequence is determined by mRNA, it is because of tRNA, which is called as an adapter molecule, which is having anticodon, which is having amino acid attachment site. It will come and correspond the process of codon, coding sequences of mRNA and anticodon sequences of tRNA is called decoding process, which is called translation, decoding. So unidentified language is made into simple language of amino acids. Our genetic code or coded language is decoded in the form of amino acid, which determines a particular protein, polypeptide chain. Here, to understand that process, the first requirement is here, ribosome, because ribosome is the place where this process occurs. So what is ribosome? For example, like this. In eukaryotes, 60S type, 40S type. And in eukaryotes, here, 5 prime cap is present, which is called 7-methyl guanosine triphosphate capping. Now here, poly A style in the eukaryotes. But here, now, the second basic requirement is amino acid. What are these amino acids? 20 different types of amino acids are structural components of various proteins. So essential amino acids, 20 different amino acids are present in various proteins synthesized by a cell. From where these 20 different amino acids enters into cell? First question. The 20 different amino acids enters into cell. For example, the body, this board is the cell and it is having nucleus and cytoplasm. Whenever that organism, a particular plant or animal, takes food or synthesizes food. So for example, it is human body or animal body. Whenever we eat food, food carries different carbohydrates, proteins. And these proteins are nothing but having amino acids. When we eat a particular type of food, that food will be digested into our body and it will break down. And here, whatever proteins we have taken inside, they will liberate the amino acid. And amino acids are abundantly present in cytoplasm of every cell in the form of a pool called amino acid pool. Amino acid pool. What is amino acid pool? Where it is present? It is present in every cell in the cytoplasm by the intake of particular food material. So, if it is a human body, if he wants to do good protein synthesis, always having enough sufficient amino acid, he has to take good food. Whatever food you have to take, that food consists of amino acids. If it are having proteins, unnecessary food, waste food is waste. So if it is having proteinaceous content, amino acids will be found present in the form of amino acid pool in every cell in the cytoplasm. So amino acid pool, amino acids present here in active state. Inactive state. Inactive state means these amino acids are not activated, not taken by any tRNA molecule unless they are going to activate. So two main components of translation, that is ribosomes and amino acids, we have taken. Ribosomes are present. What is the condition of structure of ribosome? And what is amino acids? Amino acids are abundantly present in the cytoplasm of every cell. Now, the first phase before polypeptide chain forms. In the first phase, what is meant by first phase here? Before polypeptide chain formation. In the first phase, or first, as a first step, or before to polypeptide means so many amino acids joined with peptide bonds is called polypeptide or protein. Before a protein is going to synthesize, the first step is activation of amino acid. Activation of amino acids. What is this step indicates? Amino acid, just now we have seen amino acid pool is present. Various steps. How many different? 20 types, but they may be in available hundreds, thousands. Activation of amino acid indicates that a particular amino acid joins with ATP, adenosine triphosphate energy in the presence of an enzyme, amino acyl tRNA synthetase enzyme complex. Somehow big one. Amino acyl tRNA synthetase enzyme complex. Simply, we can represent enzyme. And it can represent first amino acid, one amino acid. In the presence of this enzyme, binds with ATP. So, this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme. And finally, amino acid plus adenosine monophosphate plus, because ATP dissolved to produce monophosphate, pyrophosphate is released. Pyrophosphate, this is called amino acid adenylate enzyme complex or amino acid enzyme complex. Now, this amino acid is said to be activated amino acid. Now, this amino acid with the help of enzyme is called activated amino acid. What is activation of amino acid? Activation of amino acid means in the cytoplasm, so many amino acids are there by our food. But they are in inactive state. They have to go for the, they have the substrates for the synthesis of polypeptide. So these amino acids, which are in inactive condition, with the help of an enzyme, they were mixed with ATP. This process of combining amino acid with ATP is called activation of amino acid. After the activation of amino acid, second step is, for example, activation of amino acid. This is an enzyme. Enzyme is having receptor sites, and this is the pool of amino acids. So many amino acids are there. Amino acid 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It will take a specific amino acid and it is joins with this, with the ATP. Now, this amino acid is attached to the enzyme. Amino acid plus enzyme complex. Amino acid plus enzyme complex. Pyrophosphate is released. Now this enzyme and amino acid complex, second step, charging of tRNA. Or loading of tRNA. Charging of tRNA or loading of tRNA, or one more letter is amino acylation of tRNA. Amino acylation of tRNA. What does it mean? Now come here again. Amino acids are in inactive state. They have been activated by a particular enzyme by joining with ATP. Now here it is ready, one enzyme with amino acid. What is that? Amino acid enzyme complex is ready. Now by the process of transcription from the DNA, already several types of tRNAs are present in the cytoplasm. tRNA, transfer RNA. So many tRNAs are present in the, generally how many tRNAs should be there? 20 amino acids, 20 tRNA molecules. Or 20 amino acids are carried by 61 codons, but 61 tRNAs are not there because of OBL base, less number of tRNAs, minimum at least for information, 61 codons, 61 tRNA molecules. More than 20 tRNA molecules, third option. Maybe 20 tRNA molecules, or more than 20 tRNA molecules are present. They were also present in the cytoplasm. Now, this is called charging of tRNA. This enzyme complex with amino acid will go for a suitable specific tRNA having an anticodon and amino acid enzyme complex, AMP enzyme complex with tRNA molecule. Now tRNA is having a structure, secondary structure with anticodon 5', 3', and this enzyme will go to the tRNA's binding enzyme binding site, that is dihydrouridine arm. And it is having amino acid. This amino acid is shifted to the amino acid binding site. Amino acid binding site, which is called terminal site, acceptor site, having CCA group. Terminal CCA, 3' end CCA group. It is attached. Now, amino acid plus tRNA complex, whereas adenosine monophosphate and enzyme will go out. After shifting the amino acid from the enzyme to the tRNA, enzyme and monophosphate will go out. Now this tRNA is called charged tRNA or loaded tRNA. What is a charged tRNA? A tRNA is considered as charged when it is carrying a particular amino acid. A tRNA is charged means loaded, means acylated, means when an enzyme complex with a particular amino acid is attached to the amino acid binding site of tRNA. This process is called charging of tRNA. Now this is called charged tRNA. So these are the two main steps comes under the first phase before polypeptide chain formation. So Till now it is not started any polypeptide chain synthesis. Only the first phase where amino acids are activated, where pRNAs are activated. Now, here various conceptual questions. What is that amino acid attached to this tRNA? And what this tRNA is called? This tRNA in prokaryotes, the first tRNA amino acid complex or charged tRNA having amino acid is called formyl methionine. It was the first initiation codon for every protein synthesis. Initiation codon or starting codon is AUG, and here this AUG codes for methionine, and in prokaryotes this amino acid which is having NH2COOH RCH alkyl group NH2COOH. So at one end it is having NH2, another end it is having COOH, two ends of amino acid. Now this is the first amino acid is called methionine, and to this methionine a formyl group is attached. Formyl group is attached to the amino group as a cap. Such an amino acid is called N-formyl amino acid, and the amino acid here is AUG methionine, formyl methionine. So the first tRNA in the translation process, before translation, the first tRNA carrying amino acid is called formyl methionine tRNA. Whereas in eukaryotes, my dear students, in eukaryotes, formyl group is not attached to the normal methionine. Formyl methionine or FMET tRNA. So the first tRNA which is charged tRNA or loaded tRNA or amino acylated tRNA, by this process it is now ready with a amino acid to enter into the process of translation, protein synthesis. Two first phases where activation of amino acids, activation of tRNA or charging of tRNA. Now the polypeptide chain formation. After these two steps only we have to go to polypeptide . So polypeptide chain means protein or various types of amino acids. Which type of amino acid? The order and sequence of amino acid is determined by the mRNA in the form of codons. And how mRNA is formed? By the DNA. So DNA is the director which is going to produce mRNA, and mRNA is having coded information, genetic code, which is decoded by tRNA and presented in the form of amino acid, which determines a particular protein. Now, polypeptide chain formation, it has three steps. Polypeptide chain initiation. polypeptide chain initiation. Second, polypeptide chain elongation. Third one, polypeptide chain termination. Chain initiation, what chain initiation? Polypeptide chain initiation. Elongation, polypeptide chain elongation. Stop, polypeptide chain termination. These are the three steps comes during the formation of polypeptide chain. These steps will be only after the first two steps, that is activation of amino acid, charging of tRNA. Polypeptide chain formation, first step, polypeptide chain initiation. Polypeptide chain initiation. Here, as we studied earlier, that whenever a particular 30S subunit of ribosome approaches to mRNA, the translation starts. So the first step here in polypeptide chain initiation, 30S subunit joins with mRNA to form 30S mRNA complex. First step, 30S subunit of ribosome, it mixes with mRNA which is having 5 prime to 3 prime. How they were having SDASD sequences, Shine Delgarno sequences, which recognizes the 30S subunit. Because of SD sequences and ASD sequences, it forms a complex which is called having some sequences. And to this, our 30S is attached. This is called 30S subunit plus mRNA complex. It requires some initiation factors. Initiation factors. Initiation factors. There are three initiation factors in prokaryotes. There are 9 initiation factors in eukaryotes. For information, there are initiation. Which, what are initiation factors? They were nothing but specific proteins. Initiation factors are nothing but proteins. So some specific proteins in the form of initiation factors, they are called IF1, IF2, IF3. They were responsible for this initiation of polypeptide chain. Here the first step is initiated by initiation factor 3. Second step, charged tRNA already is having formyl methionine group. Charged tRNA 30S mRNA complex now mixes with tRNA, which tRNA? Formyl methionine tRNA to produce a complex which is called 30S mRNA tRNA complex. Thirty S subunit and a tRNA is represented by secondary structure. While it is coming, this is the 5' to 3', so in tRNA 3' to 5'. Here what it is having? It is having that particular amino acid charged tRNA. It was, this is amino acid one. Which amino acid? Formyl methionine. This complex is called 30S mRNA tRNA complex. Here 30S plus mRNA, 30S mRNA complex. Second, to this 30S mRNA complex, tRNA, charged tRNA comes and found attached to the first by anticodon UAC, and it is having corresponding amino acid. This amino acid is corresponding to the AUG. So this is called methionine. AUG codes for methionine. Now, third step. Thirtieth mRNA tRNA complex now joins with 50S large subunit. Now it joins with 50S large subunit. So finally, we are able to get complete initiation complex that could be represented like this. Diagram I will show you here. mRNA 5' to 3', and here already 30S came, 30S mRNA complex. Next, it is already having a anticodon tRNA with amino acid 1, which is called formyl methionine. Here it is having AUG, GGG, CCA, UAA, something, some sequence is there, uninterrupted, without any punctuation, without any space, without any comma or full stops. Now, to this 50S large subunit, 50S large subunit is attached. 50S large subunit is attached. This is called 70S. 70S ribosomal complex, initiation complex, 70S initiation complex, or ribosomal initiation complex. Now we will see this. The first tRNA is found in the site that is called P site. A site is empty, E site is this side. So a ribosome sub large unit is having three sites, you know, A site, acylated site, P site, peptidyl site, E site, exit site. Now what is the position of tRNA with amino acid here? It is found in the P site. So in the tRNA structure are here, they will indicate initiator tRNA. What is mean by initiator tRNA, or what do you understand about initiator tRNA? What is its location in the ribosome? Initiator tRNA is that which will take formyl methionine group, and initiator tRNA is that which will occupy P or peptidyl site as first tRNA carrying the first amino acid. Initiator peptidyl site for peptide bond formation. During chain initiation or at the end of chain initiation, they can ask hundreds of questions, tens, twenties, number of questions, various concepts. What will be the position of A? A is empty. Empty. What is P? Having charged tRNA. Now with this polypeptide chain initiated means started. So in the form of three steps, first mRNA and ribosomal subunit, second mRNA ribosomal subunit and charged tRNA, third 50S subunit. Now we'll go to the second step of polypeptide chain formation, that is polypeptide chain elongation. Polypeptide chain elongation. Polypeptide chain elongation. Polypeptide chain elongation requires elongation factors. Elongation factors. Elongation. What are these? They are nothing but specific proteins. Elongation factors. Now we have to start our story from here. Already initiated. So in the initiation last, we are having the structure like this: 5', 3', A U G G G C C A C C U U A A. I'm going to give more and more. And here our ribosome is here. So a ribosome can accommodate two codons, one codon, another codon. The space provided in the ribosome, it can accommodate. But in a ribosome, there are three places: A site, P site, E site. Now our present situation during chain elongation is, already this tRNA is here with anticodon. Anticodon. And the first amino acid, that is
formyl methionine.
Now it is in P site, whereas A site is exposed. This exposure A site is having some codon. Exposure A site is having some codon. Based upon the codon of GG, again the same process. A particular enzyme go to activate a particular amino acid, a specific enzyme. So for every amino acid to activate, specific enzymes are there. What are those enzymes? Amino acyl tRNA synthetase enzyme complex. Again, it will take another amino acid. Amino acid 2 activated, it will search for suitable tRNA. It will be charged another new fresh tRNA with a suitable amino acid will come and occupy the another tRNA with suitable amino acid will occupy it is having amino acid 2. This is called chain elongation. It means progressing growth of the chain. Now when two amino acids, two tRNA molecules are so closely associated here and bond between these two amino acid forms energetically, bond between these two amino acid forms energetically. How the bond forms here? Let us see. Here, amino acid 1. What is this amino acid 1? It has NH2 to this formyl group is attached. So it is having only one side to which COOH. This COOH side simply to this another amino acid, same amino acid 2 RCH NH2COOH. A bond between two amino acid exists by removing one water molecule HOH in the form of water molecule. Neat question. HOH in the form of one water molecule, it releases and bond forms. This bond is called amide bond, peptide bond, or simply between carboxyl group of first amino acid and the amino group of second amino acid. The bond is called peptide bond and it is generally always considered as CN bond. CN, carboxyl group of first amino acid, amino group of second amino acid, by the removal of one water molecule. Now once peptide bond is formed, this first tRNA molecule, it will release the amino acid. It will release the amino acid. It will break its anticodon bonds and it will come to the E site. It will go out. Exit means going out. Deacylated tRNA. Deacylated tRNA. Here questions are there. What is that? Every tRNA molecule which carries a particular amino acid, every tRNA molecule which carries a particular amino acid, it will come to a site, but the first tRNA molecule carrying formyl methionine, it will not go to a site, it will go to p site. That's why it is called initiator tRNA. What is the specificity of initiator tRNA? Initiator tRNA is not occupying a site at all. It will found only p site. Next, it will go out, and other tRNA will come to a site first. Now, when it goes out, second diagram here, it will be found like this. P site, A site, tRNA, having amino acid 2 and amino acid 1. So the growing polypeptide chain is attached to the tRNA present at A site. Now, chain elongation factors, and this ribosome moves on the mRNA molecule at one time, one codon, one step. So the movement of this ribosome on the mRNA from 5 prime to 3 prime direction, this movement is called translocation. Translocation means this mRNA molecule, it moves one codon at a time. Now, where and how it is, let us see. This from here, it will move to one codon. So, and this which is present at the second codon here, it will occupy which is present at A site. Now it comes to P site. tRNA molecule which is found at A site now moves to P site. It has amino acid 2 and amino acid 1. Now, based upon the third codon, AUG we have given here, GGG we have given here, CCA we have given. Based upon the third codon, another enzyme, another amino acid, another tRNA, a new tRNA with a new amino acid will come and occupy A site. Amino acid 3, and always peptide bond is from carboxyl group of amino acid here, but this peptide bond formation, our scientists identified that peptidyl transferase is the enzyme. That's why that site is called peptidyl site. Peptidyl transferase enzyme is responsible. Here, the peptidyl transferase enzyme function is 23S rRNA in prokaryotes, 28S rRNA in eukaryotes. So these two RNAs are having catalytic activity, so they are called ribozyme enzyme discovered the catalytic role of rRNA molecules in the formation of peptide bonds. So ribosomal RNAs are called structural RNAs to form structure of the ribosome, and there are catalytic RNAs for the peptide bond formation. Now again peptide bond, again same, at one time one step, one time one step. How long it will go? Chain elongation until a particular codon UAA, UAG, UGA, out of these any one will appear on the mRNA. It does not code for any amino acid, so no enzyme will be activated for amino acid, no tRNA will come. The process of polypeptide synthesis stops, termination, chain termination. We will see the details in the coming class. Again we will see this. So the termination process is stopping. In the book, when you see, all this process appears like jumbled here and there. First sentence will be in the last, last sentence will be in the first, like that. Try to receive this along with the textbook. All the best.